So welcome to this session on engineering mechanics. Today we will be looking at law of parallelogram of forces, which comes under composition of forces, and triangle law. After that we will see resolution of forces, and then we'll try to solve some examples. So first one, composition of forces. Forces may be combined, added to obtain a single force which produces the same effect as the original system of force. So what is meaning of this? So you have multiple force, suppose. So two forces are there, suppose. Two forces are there. So we can add the two forces to get a single force which has same effect as the original force. So that is known as, that single force is known as a resultant force. So what do you mean by composition? Forces may be combined, added to obtain a single force which produces the same effect as the original system of forces. The process of finding the resultant of forces is called composition of forces. So many forces will be given, and from that we have to just find one resultant. What is the single force which has the same effect, that we have to find out. That is known as composition of forces. Now in that composition of forces, law of parallelogram of forces is one method by which you can find the resultant of the force. So we'll see that. So suppose x direction we are considering force P, and at an angle theta we have another force Q, which is both the forces are acting at point O. So P and Q are the two forces, angle between them is theta, and they are acting at point O. So if two forces acting simultaneously on a body at a point are represented in magnitude and direction by two adjacent sides of a parallelogram. So here you can see a point is there on which two forces are acting simultaneously in magnitude and direction. So direction has been shown by the arrow, and magnitude it might be written over there 100 newton and so on. So magnitude and direction is given. Then their resultant is represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal of parallelogram, which passes through the intersection point of two sides representing the forces. So suppose P and Q are the two forces which represents the sides of the parallelogram. So diagonal will be there over here. So that diagonal represents what? Resultant of these two forces. So in second diagram, same thing has been shown. So here we have force P, here we have force Q, and the angle between force P and Q, it is theta. Then we have shown the diagonal over here. We have completed the parallelogram, and we have shown the diagonal over here. Now this diagonal is what? It is resultant of P and Q, and this resultant angle with respect to P, it is angle alpha. Now after this, we have extended this horizontal line of action of force P, and then we have drawn a vertical from point B. So we have drawn a parallelogram, we have completed a parallelogram OABC, and the diagonal is OB. Now we are constructing a triangle at the end of the parallelogram, outside the parallelogram. So from B, point B, we have drawn a vertical which intersects the extension of this force P, line of action of force P at D. So here also we have formed one triangle, which is right angle triangle. Now we'll see some angles. So angle between P and force Q, it is theta. So if this is P and this is the opposite side of the parallelogram, so if this is Q, this is also Q. So angle between this, we have extended P force over here. So angle between P and Q, it is theta. So same theta which is written over here has been shown over here. So in this triangle, triangle A, B, D, what will be the opposite side? It will be hypotenuse multiplied by sin theta. And what will be the adjacent side? It will be the hypotenuse, which is Q, multiplied by cos theta. Okay, now in triangle, if you consider this triangle, in triangle O D B. Okay, so in this triangle, blue triangle, what you can write? OB square is equal to OD square plus BD square. Now this OD is made up of OA and AD. So OB square will remain as it is, equal to OA plus AD whole square plus BD square. Now we'll substitute the values. So what is OB? This is what? Resultant R. So R square, I have written over here, R square. Now OA, what is this OA? It is P. So P. Then what is AD? AD is Q cos theta plus Q cos theta the whole square plus what is BD? BD is Q sin theta. So Q sin theta whole square. So just open the bracket. So P square plus 2PQ cos theta plus Q square cos square theta plus open this bracket. So it will be Q square into sin square theta. This is Q square cos square theta and this is Q square sin square theta. So you can take Q square common. So here I have taken Q square common and sin square theta plus cos square theta, which is remaining, it will become 1. So P square is written over here. Then only part remaining out of these two term, it will be Q square plus the remaining part 2PQ cos theta. So from here we'll get the value of resultant R is equal to under root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. So this is law of parallelogram of forces. So if we have two forces P and Q, which represents the side of parallelogram, then the diagonal represents magnitude and direction of the diagonal represents the resultant, which is given by this equation, R equal to under root P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. Now we have to calculate this angle alpha, which is made by R with P. So if you consider this triangle again, what we can write, tan alpha is BD upon OD. And what is BD? Q sin theta. So BD is Q sin theta and OD is P plus Q cos theta. So alpha will be what? Alpha will be tan inverse of this bracket. Next we will see other method of composition of forces, triangle law of forces. So again, I have shown over here, the force P is there and force Q is there. Force P and force Q are two adjacent sides of a parallelogram. Then diagonal represents what? Resultant. This we have seen. Now, if you see, these forces are what? Vectors. So you can move this vector. This Q can be taken towards right and you will form a triangle over here. So this will be, see the arrows now. Arrows are important. Okay, let me show you the arrows. So P is towards from left to right. It is in this direction. Then Q, it is starting from the end of the arrowhead of P. So from here Q is starting like this. So this is Q and resultant, whatever the closing side is there, that is resultant, and that resultant arrow is opposite to the P and Q arrow. So P and Q, they are going in sequence, but the resultant arrow is there, that is opposite in direction. Okay, so here you can see we have formed a triangle. Now angle between P and Q, it is what? It is theta. So here you can see this X direction we have force P and this inclined one it is Q. So angle between P and Q is what? Here you can see it is angle between P and Q, it is theta. So here also angle between this is P and this is Q. So it will be theta. Now if you consider resultant, the resultant angle between resultant and P, it is what? Alpha. So here also you can see angle between P and resultant, it is alpha. Now since this angle is theta, what will be the adjacent, this one angle, this angle will be 180 minus theta. Now either you can take this Q towards right hand side to complete the triangle like this one, first diagram, or you can keep this Q as it is as shown in the second diagram, and you can move this P bar, force on the top side over here. So you can make the triangle like this. Okay, both will give you same results. So both will be giving you same results. This you have to note. Now we'll write down the cosine rule. So R square is equal to P square plus Q square minus 2PQ cos 180 minus theta. So cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. So R square is equal to P square plus Q square plus this will become plus. So plus 2PQ cos theta. So from here we will get R is equal to under root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. Now this, whatever we are getting equation over here of resultant, which is of P and Q, it is similar to that law of parallelogram. Okay, so here you can see this resultant R equal to under root P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. So it will be same. Now we have seen composition of forces. So there we found out what is resultant. Okay, so number of forces are there and we are finding resultant. Now the second thing is what? Resolution of force. So what do you mean by resolution of force? The process of breaking the force into a number of components which are equivalent to the given forces is called resolution of force. So what is meaning of this? A single force is there and we are getting number of components. Suppose X component is there and Y component is there. So that is known as what? Resolution of force. So one force is there and we are breaking the force into X component and Y component. That is called what? Resolution. Now it is not necessary that it is X component and Y component only. Why? Because we can use parallelogram and triangle law also. So what are the methods of this? Law of parallelogram of forces, triangle law of forces. So law of parallelogram of forces and triangle law of forces can be used for both composition of force and resolution of force. Okay. Now third method, which is very important, which we are going to see over here, is resolution of force into rectangular components of force. So we'll see the diagram first. So take the example, a flat surface is there and on the flat surface a block has been placed. Now from the center of the block, we are marking center of the block as O. So we have drawn X axis and Y axis from the center of the block. And a force is acting, the point of application of this force F, it is from the point O, center of the block. So the force is away from the body, so body is being pulled. Now the force angle with respect to horizontal is what? Theta. Now this same diagram can be represented on XY graph. Okay, so XY plane. So here you can see X axis is there and Y axis is there. We have marked force F and we have point O over here. And what is the angle force F making with respect to horizontal? It is theta. So same thing we have represented in some other form. Now we are trying to resolve this force F into rectangular components of force, meaning X component and Y component. So here you can see force F, it is resolved into two components. X direction is called Fx and Y direction is called Fy. Now how I have resolved this force, that is important. So to understand the resolution, one principle you have to remember, from the point of application of force, okay, from point of application, meaning in this case point O, force is going in this direction. Okay, so from the tail of that force, you have to fit the given force in a quadrant. Okay, so we have four quadrants. If you see the graph paper, we have four quadrants, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. So here you can see this force which is there in right side, okay, right side in upward direction. This force, it is fitting in which quadrant? First quadrant. That is why when I am resolving this force F, x component is on positive x axis and y component is on positive y axis. Now we'll see when we are solving example that forces are in different quadrant. So when you resolve the force, in that case the sum fx and fy component might be in some other direction, okay, it might be negative y, it might be negative x. So just you have to take care of that. So we'll see that in the numerical. Now what we can do is, since these are vectors, we can complete the triangle. So fx is on this side, we can just move this fy on right hand side. So fy will come over here. So fx and fy will be continuous, and this f, it is as if it is resultant. So fx will be in this direction, continuously fy will be there, and you can see the direction of f arrowhead, it will be reverse of that. So just to represent this, I'll show you. So this is fx as shown over here. So this is the direction of fx, and from B point this will be fy. So arrow is continuous like this, and if you see arrow of f, which is, you can call this as resultant, so it is opposite to the direction of A and B, okay, it is not continuously going and completing the cycle to point O. Now same thing is represented on the next slide. So here you can see this force F, okay, this force F which is acting at point O and has the inclination of theta with respect to horizontal, when it is resolved, this is the fx and this is fy component. So this is forming a triangle. Now if you see the triangle over here, what you can write, sine theta by using trigonometry, sine theta will be what? Opposite fy upon hypotenuse f. So sine theta is fy upon f, and what is cos theta? Cos theta is adjacent, so fx upon hypotenuse f. So cos theta is fx upon f. So from here what we can get is value of this fy and fx. So what is this fy? Cross multiply this f towards left hand side, so you will get fy is equal to f sin theta, and fx is equal to f cos theta. So what will be f? Since this is right angle triangle, what will be f? F is hypotenuse. So what you can write, f is equal to under root of fx square plus fy square. And what will be theta? What is this theta? It is inclination of the resultant force F with respect to horizontal. Okay, and that is, we are considering acute angle. So we will be using mod when we are calculating that theta. So theta is equal to, it will be what? Theta is equal to, use the tan ratio, tan theta is equal to Fy upon Fx. So theta will be equal to tan inverse, use here mod. Tan inverse mod of Fy upon Fx. Now what is the sign convention? As we have discussed previously, the force in this example, it was given in first quadrant. So Fx and Fy were positive. But if you consider, so just let me show you this. So just you have to draw a graph like this. So I have drawn X axis and Y axis. Now positive X X in right side, it is positive X. X on left side, it is negative X. Next, Y in upward direction, it is positive, and Y in downward direction, it is negative. This is the sign convention which we are going to follow. So just now forget about the second, this is first quadrant. This is first quadrant. This is second quadrant. This is third quadrant. And this is fourth quadrant. Now for some time, forget about quadrant 2, 3 and 4. Just concentrate on quadrant 1. So if you consider quadrant 1, what is direction of fx? It is positive. So here you can see fx is positive. What is direction of y? Fy is positive. So this is about first quadrant. Now go to quadrant number 2. Forget about quadrant 1, 3 and 4. So if you see this quadrant number 2, what is direction of fx? it is negative. What is direction of FY? It is positive, it is upward. So based on quadrant you have to decide the direction, okay, whether it is positive or negative, sign convention. Now see the third quadrant. X is negative, so Fx is negative, and Y is also negative, so Fy is negative. See the fourth quadrant. X is positive, so Fx is positive, and Y is negative, so Fy is negative. So resultant force. So what do you mean by resultant force? It is a single force or a single couple or a single force and couple which can replace given force system. What is the meaning of this definition? Suppose a number of forces have been given in a system. So we'll replace all the forces by only single force. So that will be resultant force. Then suppose the given system has only couple. So we can replace the given system by single couple. Or if the system has a force as well as couple, in that case we can replace the system by single force and couple. So that is called resultant. What do you mean by equilibrant? Equilibrant is a single force which brings the system to equilibrium. Thus equilibrant is equal in magnitude, opposite in direction, and collinear to resultant force. So whatever resultant we have, opposite to that, equal in magnitude, will be equilibrant force. Okay, it will be equilibrant. Now, numericals on resultant force, we will be having concurrent force system, then we will be having parallel force system, and then we will be having general force system. So we'll see what are the steps involved for resultant of concurrent force system using method of resolution, rectangular force components. So what is the first step? Find Rx. So what is Rx? Rx is equal to summation of Fx. So resolve all the forces along the horizontal x axis and take the algebraic sum of force components considering the proper sign convention. So this is step number one. What is second step? Ry is equal to summation Fy. So resolve the forces along vertical y axis and take algebraic sum of forces of components considering proper sign convention. So we'll see the steps when we are solving the numerical. So first step is Rx is equal to summation Fx. Second step is Ry equal to summation Fy. Now third step will be finding resultant. So resultant will be what? It will be under root of summation Fx square plus summation Fy square. And what will be the angle theta? So to find the inclination of line of action of resultant force with respect to Fx or horizontal, that will be tan theta is mod of summation Fy upon summation Fx. As we had seen in that resolution of rectangular components, it is same like that. So theta will be tan inverse of summation Fy upon summation Fx. Now one important thing you have to note over here is, here I have written mod, meaning we have to always use Fx and Fy positive for finding theta with horizontal. So always this theta will be what? Acute angle with respect to x axis. And this will be the direction position of the resultant. So after resolving the given forces, we have to find the resultant, and resultant will be based on this quadrant system which we had discussed. Okay, now first type of numerical on resultant is resultant of concurrent force system. So I'll read the question. The body is acted upon by forces as given below. Find the resultant of these forces. So 1 to 6 forces are given. All the forces are acting from point O. Now from here, what you can understand from the last line, all the forces are acting from point O. So first thing is, it is coplanar system. And second one is, it is concurrent, because all the forces are acting, line of action of all the forces is passing through a single point. Okay. So we'll draw this one by one. Now here you can see, what is the magnitude given? 50 Newton acting due east. So here the force direction has been given as east, west, north, south. Okay, so we'll draw the axis first. So suppose this is right side will be what? It will be east. Left side will be west. Considering top is north. So we'll draw north and south now. So top side is north and bottom side is south. Now what is the first force? 50 Newton acting due east. So east is towards right. So from point O, I'll mark point O at the center, and from point O towards right we'll have 50 Newton force. So first one will be 50 Newton. Now second one is 100 Newton force 50 degree north of east. So north of east means what? So east is this one. So north of east means it will be in which quadrant? First quadrant. So 50 degrees. So I'll draw this. Now this one will be, magnitude has been given as 100 Newton and the angle is 50 degree. Next force, 75 Newton, 20 degree west of north. Okay, so main side is north and we have to go west of north. Means it will be which quadrant? Second quadrant. So angle is just 20 degree. So I'll draw that. So this will be that force, which is 75 Newton and angle is 20 degree, which is west of north. Understand the language, west of north. Next one, 120 Newton acting 30 degree south of west. So south of west means this is west, and south of west means it will be bottom of that. So it will be somewhere like this. So south of west, and what is the angle? 30 degrees. So this will be 120 Newton and angle is 30 degree. Next, 90 Newton force acting 25 degree west of south. So west of south, which is the main side? South. So south is the main side, and west of south means it will be this one. And what is the angle given? It is 25. So this angle will be 25. So I'll draw that. So this force, what is the magnitude of this? 90 Newton and angle is 25 degree. And the last force is 80 Newton acting 40 degree south of east. So this is east, and south of east means this one. What is the angle given? This angle is 40 degree. So we'll draw that one. So this force, angle is 40 degree and magnitude is 80 Newton. Okay, now what we have to do is basically we have to resolve these forces one by one, and finally we have to find what is the resultant of this concurrent force system. Okay, number of forces are given and we have to replace this force system by a single force. Okay, and that single force will have magnitude and direction. So what we will do now, we'll consider one by one different components. So we'll resolve the force. Now how to resolve the force? I told you before also, you have to resolve from arrow tail, okay, tail side. So if you consider this 50 Newton force, 50 Newton, it is already in which direction? X direction. So no need to resolve that force. Okay, we have to just resolve the angular forces, not X direction and Y direction forces. So next one is which one? 100 Newton force. So we'll resolve this 100 Newton force into X and Y component. So what will be the X component and Y component? So X, if you consider this angle, here the angle is 50 degree. So angle between 100 Newton and horizontal, it is 50 degree. So here also the angle between this horizontal and the 100 Newton force, it will be 50 degree. And we have seen that the X component, whenever you have angle with respect to horizontal, okay, whichever, suppose the force is this one, X direction force. So what will be magnitude of that force? It will be hypotenuse, which is 100, and cos 50. Okay, now what will be the Y component? It will be sine. So it will be 100 sine 50. Okay, next we will see the 75 Newton force. Now it is in which quadrant? Second quadrant. And again you have to resolve it from tail side. So again I'll resolve it like this. Okay, so I have to resolve this. So this is X direction and this is Y direction. Now angle over here is with respect to vertical. So this is 20 degree. Here you can see it is angle is with respect to vertical. 75 degree, 75 Newton is with respect to north. So now cos component, it will be Y component. Why? Because we have to just look whatever the force is given, 75 Newton, with respect to that force, either X or Y. Angle is given with respect to X or with respect to Y. So in first case when 100 Newton was there, angle was with respect to X axis. So X component had cos and Y component had sin. Now here Y component has the angle 20 degree. Okay. So Y component will be cos component. So I'll write down. So Y component will be how much? 75 cos, angle is 20. What about X component? X component will be, now you have to see the direction also. Okay, here direction it was plus only. Here also it was plus. Now 75 cos 20, it is a positive Y direction, so it is also plus. Now if you see the west direction, that force will be negative. So minus, don't forget this minus. Minus of 75 sine 20. Now we'll resolve 120 Newton force. Now 120 Newton, it is in which quadrant? Third quadrant. So from the tail side, we will resolve it like this. And angle is given with respect to X. So this will be the angle. So X component will be cos and Y component will be sine. It's like that. So let me draw the components now. So this will be X component and this will be Y component and the arrow will be in this direction. Okay, just draw the axis arrows. Now since X component angle is with respect to X component, so this will be angle 30 degree. So component will be minus of 120 cos 30. And Y, it is downward, so don't forget negative sign. So minus 120 sine 30. So basically what you have to pay attention over here is three things. First one is sine, second one is magnitude of force, and third one here we are considering that cos or sine component. Okay, next, sine is due to the quadrant. It will be left means it will be negative. Right means it is positive. Downward means it is negative. Upward means it is positive. Next we will see 90 Newton force. Now 90 Newton force is in third quadrant. So we have to resolve this. So this will be X direction resolution and this will be Y direction resolution. Now what is the angle? Angle is given with respect to vertical. This 90 Newton has angle with respect to vertical. So this is 25 degree. So now vertical component will be which component? Cos component. Remember that. And arrow is downward. So downward means it will be negative minus, then we have to write down what magnitude. So 90, then since angle is with respect to vertical, so it will be vertical will be cos 25. Now we'll write the horizontal component. Now horizontal component which I have shown over here, okay, this component, it is towards which direction? Arrow is towards left, so it will be minus, first thing. Then magnitude of force is 90, so 90, and angle is with respect to y, so this will become sine component. So sine angle is 25. Then last force, 80 newton, it is in fourth quadrant, and from the tail side I am resolving the force. From here I'll resolve the force, so this is x direction and this is y direction. Now in case of x direction, what will be the component? See the direction, arrow, it is towards right, so it will be positive. So it will be positive. What is the magnitude? 80. And see the angle. Angle is with respect to x axis, so this is 40. So x component will be cos component. So cos 40. Cos 40. Now y component, you can see the direction, it is negative, downward. So it will be negative. Magnitude is 80 and it will become sine, angle is 40. Now we'll have to solve this question. So what is the first step we have seen in the concurrent force system? First step is Rx is equal to summation Fx. So we have to just add all the forces in x direction. So what is the first one? First one, if you see, it is 50 newton. So we'll write down plus 50. Then second force, you can see this is towards right, so this is plus 100 cos 50. Next one, we have to just see x component which we have resolved. Okay, next one is this one. Sign we have already written, it is negative. So I'll write down minus 75 sine 20. Next force is 120 newton. Its x component is written over here. So we have to just write down that component, minus 120 cos 30. Next force is 90 newton, x component is minus 90 sine 25. Minus 90 sine 25. After that, next force is 80 newton force and x component is plus 80 cos 40. So just you have to write down that, plus 80 cos 40. So if you calculate this on your calculator, you will get the value as 7.95 newton. Now this is Rx which we have calculated, and this Rx, it is positive, right? So we had discussed before the sign convention. If x force is positive, it will be in which direction? Right or left? It will be right direction. So you have to write down in bracket direction of that force also. So it is towards right. Next we will write summation Fy. So summation, so Ry, second step, Ry is equal to summation Fy. Okay, so summation Fy, so we'll consider all the forces in vertical direction. Okay, either upward or downward. So if you consider first force, 50 newton, it is in x direction, so it won't be having any y component. Second force 100 Newton, it is inclined, so it has y component, which is 100 sine 30. So we'll write down first one plus 100 sine 30. Sorry, sine plus 100 sine 50. Next force 75 Newton. What is the vertical component? It is plus 75 cos 20. So plus 75 cos 20. Next component, next force is 120 Newton. Its y component is minus 120 sine 30. So minus 120 sine 30. Next force 90 Newton. So it has minus 90 cos 25. So minus 90 cos 25. And the last force is 80 Newton and y component is minus 80 sine 40. So minus 80 sine 40. So if you do the calculation on calculator, you will get Ry value. So Ry, you will get it as 45.91 Newton. Now this has negative sign, so it is negative. So negative means, see, now y is upward is positive and downward is what? Negative. So what you will do is, again you will write Ry is equal to 45.91 Newton and direction is negative, so it will be downward. Now we'll calculate the resultant. We have got x, we have got y, so we have to calculate the resultant. So third step will be what? Calculation of R. So how to calculate resultant? Resultant, so I'll just show you the diagram of this. So what we have done is, basically we have calculated, if you consider this diagram, okay, if you consider this diagram, if you see this diagram, what we have basically done is, we have calculated Rx. Rx is in which direction? Rx is towards right. So net Rx we have calculated, it is towards right. So this will be Rx. Then what we are doing, we have calculated Ry. What is the direction of this Ry? It is downward. So it will be downward like this. So you have to show this. So this is Ry. So if you see the quadrant which is Rx and Ry is forming, it is which quadrant? Fourth quadrant. So resultant will lie in which quadrant? Fourth quadrant. Okay, this is the conclusion which we get from this activity. So we have calculated Rx, we plotted the Rx. We calculated Ry, we plotted the Ry. And if we see Rx and Ry, it forms a fourth quadrant. So resultant of all the forces, which forces? This 50 Newton. Then 100 Newton, 75 Newton, 120 Newton, 90 Newton and 80 Newton will lie in which quadrant? Fourth quadrant. Okay, so what we will do now, we have to calculate R. Now, to calculate R, I'll show you a simplified diagram of this. Rx is towards right. Okay, so Rx is like this. Rx is towards right. And Ry is towards bottom. So this is Ry. Now whatever resultant is there, it will lie where? In this fourth quadrant. The resultant will lie in fourth quadrant. Now angle we have to calculate. Okay, magnitude and angle of this resultant we have to calculate. So what we will do? This, if you consider, we can convert this into a triangle. Okay, so how to do that? So this will be, this is suppose Rx. Then suppose this is resultant, this is resultant, and this is Ry. So this is Rx, this is Ry, and this is R, and this is angle theta. So what will be R? How to calculate R? R will be under root of Rx square plus Ry square. R is what? Hypotenuse. So R will be equal to under root of Rx square plus Ry square, and Rx we have calculated. what is the value of Rx? It is 7.95. So 7.95 square plus 45.91 square under root. So from here I'll get the resultant R is equal to 46.59 Newton. After this we have to find the direction of that resultant, which is theta. So what will be theta? Theta, we have seen the formula, it will be tan inverse mod of summation fy upon summation fx, or it will be ry upon rx, one and the same. So it will be equal to, theta will be tan inverse summation fy. What is summation fy? Here itself we have written summation fy 45.91. So 45.91 divided by what is summation fx? 7.95. So from here we'll get value of theta. So theta, therefore theta is equal to 80.18 degree. So this is the answer. So now you can understand, we'll complete the diagram which we started to draw over here. So Rx value is how much? It is 7.95 Newton. Ry, what is Ry value? It is downward, na? So we have considered downward, no need to write down the negative sign. So it is 45.91 Newton. And the resultant, if you see, what is the angle made by the resultant? This theta, it will be 80.18 degree. So this will be your final answer. So we'll again go through the numerical. We have completed the numerical. What we did? This is the numerical on which system? Concurrent force system. Okay. So from the given data, we had first drawn the diagram. Okay. Now after drawing that diagram, we resolved the forces, given forces in X and Y component. Okay. So each force was divided. Then we used the different steps which we had decided earlier. Rx equal to summation fx, then ry equal to summation fy, and whenever you are calculating, don't forget the sign convention, it is very important. Okay, so first answer we got Rx is 7.95 Newton, second answer we got ry is 45.91 Newton downward. Then we calculated the resultant R, and then we calculated theta. Okay, and based on this we plotted Rx, Ry, and we found that the resultant which is lying, it is in which quadrant? Fourth quadrant. Okay, and the angle made by the resultant with respect to horizontal, it is 80.18 degree. Okay, now I'll take up some small examples over here so that your doubts are cleared. Okay, so I know many students might be having doubts on the resolution part. Okay, so I'll ask you some questions and we'll have some 5 to 10 minutes interactive session. Okay, suppose this is the force. This force magnitude is 100 Newton. Okay, now its angle with respect to Y, it is 30 degree. Now I have to resolve the components. So this will lie in which quadrant? First answer me that. Second quadrant. So what you have to do, see, understand, this will be the point from where force is starting. So clearly you can see it is in second quadrant. So from the tail side, you have to just draw it like this. So this will be upward direction, this will be x direction. Now where to show this angle, 30 degree angle? It will be with respect to this x force or y force? Y force. So this angle will be 30 degree. Now just tell me, how I will write this y direction force? Okay, you can tell me. How to write this? First you have to write down what direction. First you have to see the arrowhead. It is upward or downward? It is upward. So it will be what? Positive. So plus. then 100 and it will be cos 30. Okay, what about this x? X component, how to write this? So x is in which direction? Left side. So it will be negative. So minus. So minus, then it will be 100 sine 30. One more question I'll ask. Suppose a point is shown over here and a force is acting like this. And now I want to resolve this force. This force is suppose 50 Newton and angle with respect to horizontal is 30 degree. So how to resolve this force? So what will be x component? Minus 50 cos 30. And what will be y component? Minus 50 sine 30. Okay, so we'll see that. So I'll resolve this. You can resolve either from this point or you can resolve from this point. Okay, but in the numerical I didn't resolve from the origin. Why? Because agar maine sub forces origin se hi agar resolve kiya to ek ke upar overlap hoga aur kuch samjhega nahi. It will be complete khichdi. If I resolve everything from point O. Okay, so that is why what I did was I resolved it from the, you can see it was resolved not from point O, I took some, I left some distance. Okay, now in this case since only one force is given, you can resolve from point O. Okay, so forget about that. Now we'll see the direction, magnitude and direction of force. So this force is towards left hand side and angle with respect to x is 30. So x component will be cos component. And since it is towards left, first you have to write down the negative sign. So minus. Then students, I'll tell you, you will forget this negative and positive sign. Okay, exam mein aap log kya bhulne wale ho? Negative and positive sign hi bhulne wale ho. So this will be minus, then 50 cos 30. And if you see y, it is downward. So don't forget negative. So negative 50, it will be sin 30. It's like that. So I hope this resolution of force is clear. Next lecture now we will be solving some advanced numerical. Even though this was also complicated, but the numerical trigonometry will be there. Lot of things will be there. Okay. So I'll send you the PDF in the Google Classroom. If you have not joined the Google Classroom, you have to join the Google Classroom as well.